Good morning, one and all. Today we will see or we will start a subject, database systems, for third year engineering students. So I'll shortly introduce about the subject. First I'll introduce the subject name, database systems. So the subject contains 6 units, unit 1, unit 2 up to unit 6. So for that subject or for this subject we are having a total 6 units, and the textbook for these subjects are, we can use a database system concepts by Tata McGraw-Hill publication 6th edition, written by Henry Korth, Abraham and S. Sudarsh. And second book we can use the database management systems by McGraw-Hill publication by Raghu Ramakrishnan and Johnson JRK. So now I'll introduce about the some teaching learning hours of this subject. So for this subject we are taking 3 lectures per week, as well as this subject contains 2 hours practical for per batch. So the subject having a practical oral examination for 50 marks. So we will start a subject. So chapter 1, database system architecture and data models. So see the points we are going to cover in this topic. Database system management, it contains, first we will see the purpose of database system. Why we are going to need or why we are going to use the database system concept. So after that we will consider a data abstraction concept. It is nothing but we will call that view of data. The next one is the data independence. The next one, data definition language. And the last point for the database system architecture, that is the first part of the topic, is the data manipulation language. So we will start point to point. First, we will see the difference between data and database management system. Data means what? Data means a collection of related data. See, what is the difference I am telling? The data and database management system. So we can see here, data means what? The collection of interrelated or related data. And when we are going to use or we are going to manage that data, then we are going to call it as the database management system. So totally the definition is what? Collection of interrelated data and the set of programs to access that related data. You understand what I am telling? Data means what? Interrelated data. That is the collection of interrelated data. And the management system means what? The set of programs. The set of programs which are we are going to access that data. So data is nothing but the information. So the database management system provides an environment that is both convenient and efficient to use. Then in DBMS we are going to learn how the data we are going to use in an efficient way. So we all know that our day-to-day life examples related with the database. See here, some examples I have written here. First one is the banking. Nowadays, we all are in home. So, all we are doing our transaction digitally. So, you all know that all the banking work we are going to use by digital concept. So, all the transactions we are doing. So, at the back end, the transactions are going to save in some database. Okay, second one is the airlines. In airline sector also, we can do the reservations, schedules of that reservations. Again, they are going to contain or they are going to collect that information to their databases. For example, passenger, passenger name, what passenger's information, arrival time, departure time of that passengers. So all that information is going to collect under the airlines database. Okay. The next one is the universities. So you all given the online examinations. You are going to fill the form online. So all that forms, all that marks, all that entries of marks, examination details, they are going to save in some database. Okay. So in the universities, that is the education and examination fields also, we are going to use database concept. Again, the sales. So in a business, it is related with the customers, products details, purchase details. So all we are going to use the database in the sales department also. So next one is, we can take the example manufacturing process. So in a production department, inventory management, orders, and last one is the obviously supply chain. So all these are going to use in a manufacturing process. Their database contains all their history. So last example we are giving the human resources. That means all the employee records who are doing the job, and according to job, their salaries, their tax deductions, all are saved in a one database. Okay. So all these examples or all these are the applications of database. We can say that we can collect the data, we can collect the interrelated data in a database, and when the time of access, we are going to use some programs to access that data for our convenience, or as per the user requirement, we can continue with that database. Okay, so database touch all the aspects of our life. So you can see here, banking, airlines, universities, sales, manufacturing, human resources. And in nowadays, all we are using simply a digital concept for the our life. So all these examples are touch our all aspects of our life. Okay, then next we will see what is the purpose of database system. See, in the early days, database applications were built on top of file systems. So you all know the meaning of file. File means in the file also we are collecting the information. But there is some drawbacks for the file system. We can see one by one the drawbacks of using file system for storing the data. Okay, you people understand? In the file system also we can store the data, and also in some database system also we can store the data. Both they are having the same work, but in the file system and the database system, so many differences are there. So we can first see the drawbacks of file system. The first one is the data redundancy and inconsistency. So see here, what do you mean by redundancy and inconsistency? So multiple file formats, duplication of information in different files. See here, when we are going to save, we are going to work on some files, then so many times a multiple data of same format or the different formats we are saving, we are storing in our machine. So after so many work, we are going to duplicate that data in different files. So redundancy means duplication of the same data. For the disadvantage of that, what we are accessing, or we are accessing some cost or extra cost for that data, as well as we can invest some extra memory for saving or for storing that particular data. You can understand, redundancy means duplication of the same data on our machine. So that redundancy is going to convert into inconsistency of data. Okay, so for avoiding that duplication of the same data or saving our memory, our cost, we can use the database system here. So next one is difficulty in accessing that data. See here, need to write a new program to carry out each new task. So in a file system, our data is scattered. Okay, our data is scattered in many files. So when we are going to access that data, each time we we write a new program to taking that data back. So every time we are going to access that file, that data is scattered. Again, we are going to write a new program for accessing that data. So when we are going to use file system, then we are difficulty in accessing that particular data over so many files. So this is the second drawback of file system. Again, the next part is the or next point of or next drawback of file system is the data isolation. So see here, multiple files and formats, writing a new program is difficult. So it totally depends on, see here, difficulty in accessing data. So it results into data isolation. Okay, we need to write again new format. Again, we are going to access that program. Again, we are going to access that data. So it is going to result into isolation, data isolation. And last one is the integrity problems. So see here, integrity constraints. For example, we are taking here account balance is greater than zero, become a part of a program code. Hard to add the new constraints or change the existing one. See here. Here we are giving one example of bank, otherwise employee salary. So when we are taking 100 employees and we are giving some condition, what condition is there? The account balance, the whose account balance is greater than 100 or 200. Show me that account or show me the employee record of that particular employee. In a file system, we already told here what I am telling here, difficulty in accessing data. So we are accessing a data for that 100 files, for that 100 employee records. For each program, we are going to add a part of program code is the account balance is greater than zero. Otherwise, whatever condition you are putting, account balance or that salary of that employee is greater than 100. So each time we are going to add this line of code for 100 employees. Okay. So integrity constraint. Constraint means condition. One condition I am putting here. I want the record of employees whose salary is greater than 100. So in a file system, so many times we are going to write a program and again every program we are going to write that condition. So here also in every file we are hard to add a new constraint means condition or change the existing ones. Okay. So integrity problems also occurs in a file system. Understand what are the drawbacks of using file system? Data redundancy and inconsistency, difficulty in accessing data, data isolation, and last one is the integrity problems. When we are putting the conditions, that also problematic in a file system. So again, the next one is the atomicity problems also there. So see here, what is the atomicity problem? Failures may leave database in an inconsistent state with the partial updates carried out. For example, we are taking here, transfer of funds from one account to another should either complete or not happen at all. So atomicity is one of the condition for the proper transaction. See here, when we are having some joint accounts as well as the single accounts, we are doing the transaction. Suppose I am having one account and you are having the one account. I transferred the amount of 1000 from my account to your account. Okay. So many times related with the file system, what happens? I am going to transfer that funds. Okay. From my account. But it is not updated in my accounts also and your accounts also. Okay. I am having a 2000. I am going to transfer 1000 to your account. What is the amount in my account? 1000. Okay. But sometimes what is happened? Transfer fund operation is carried out. But that they are not showing the updates of that amount. This is happened with some of the file systems we are using traditionally. Okay. So that is the atomicity of updates. Either they are going to carry out whole work, otherwise it not happens at all. So that problem is also with the file system. So another problem is the concurrent access by multiple users. See here, concurrent access needed for performance, which is uncontrolled concurrent access can lead into inconsistency. See examples, after example we will explain. Two people reading a balance and updating it at the same time. Okay, so see here, read and write property is there with every transaction. So concurrent access means what? Two people's, we are taking example of joint account, me and you having a one joint account, and at the same time we are both are reading or accessing the same account, that is the concurrent access we are doing on the same account. So at the time the data variance is occur. So two people's reading a balance and updating it at the same time. So in a file system that is problematic. I am also transferring money to you, you are also transferring money to me. So we are taking the operations one by one. So first I will write, again you will read, I will write. So that concurrent access by multiple users at the same account, it will be problematic with the file system. Okay, and last one, and it is important problem, is the security problem. So see here, redundancy, accessing data, isolation, constraint problems, atomicity problems, concurrent access by multiple users problem, say they all lead into a security problems. Okay, so these are the some drawbacks of file system. So we'll continue with what are the solution regarding this. So for that we are using the database system concept overall. Okay, so first, when we are using a different applications related to database, so we need to understand first database system architectures, and for that we need to study some data models. With the help of that data models we are going to use some data operations on the database, and then we are going to ready for accessing that data with the different properties. Okay, so the first point we will see here, the concept of data abstraction. So the first characteristics of database system is it provides an abstract view of data. What is the abstract view of data? That is, the system hides certain details of how that data are stored and maintained. Okay, the abstract view means hidden view of data. So the database system that are not showing how the particular data is stored and maintained at the back end. Directly we are using that application, but how that data is stored, how that data is processed, how that data is maintained, that they are not showing to the user. The system hides that certain details related to data from the user. So this is called as the abstract view of data, and collectively we are called as a data abstraction concept. Okay, so that abstract view, otherwise we can say that data abstraction, the three main levels are there, or they are designed at the level wise how we are going to abstract the data, how we are going to view the abstract data to the user, or as well as how they are going to process the data at the back end. Means database management systems, how they are provides an abstract view at the level wise. So the first, see here, which level is there? Physical level.
See here, lowest level, physical level is the lowest level, means at the low level, which describes how a record is stored. So, it describes the complex level data structures in detail. What physical level describes? Only the how record is stored. Whatever data is stored, see here the word how. Okay. Next one is the logical level. So, it is related with the programming also. We can see that. It is the middle level. Okay. Physical level is the lowest level and logical level is the middle level, which describes what data is stored in a database and the relationship among the data. See here, physical level, what it is going to describe? How a record is stored. And logical level, what it describes? What data? How? Next one is the what data is stored in a database and what is the relationship among that data? How they are interrelated with each other? What is the relationship among the different databases? Okay. And the view level is the highest level of database. So, highest level, which describes only a part of the entire database, may provide many views for the same database. We stored only a part of the entire database may provide many views for the same database. It exists simply by their interaction with the system. See, you understand what are the three levels of the data abstraction? First one is the physical level, second one is the logical level, and last one is the view level. So, physical level, how a record is stored, logical level, what data is stored along with the relationship, and view levels, it is the highest level. It shows a part of the entire database according to the user requirement. So, for the whole database, from the whole database, the users can access a part of database also. So, the view level provides many views for the same database. So, it interaction with the system. Okay. You can see here what is the architecture of the data abstraction. See here, physical level, lowest level, logical level, middle level, and the view level. You can see here, it is a part of database from the entire database. It shows how the data is stored. Logical level shows what is there and how they are interconnected, and view level is simply a user level. The user can access a different view from the same data. Okay, you understand what we studied? So, data abstraction is the most important part of the database management system. It simply abstracts a view of data. The next point we will see in the next session.